This week on Maker Update, talking with your plants, 3D printed light sculpture, building a blinky patch bay, magic shutdown, custom gears, and a crash course on every Dremel bit. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, the show where we update you on cool things makers are making. I hope you're doing well. I've got a fun show for you. Let's get started with the project of the week. Matt Reed has a guide and video up that explores the idea of adding AI-powered conversation skills to your plants. His write-up explains how, using a Raspberry Pi computer running ChatGPT-4 code, you can fairly easily build an AI interaction that draws conclusions on its own state and environment using connected sensors. We've seen IoT dashboard systems for gardens for years now, showing stats for soil moisture and sunlight, but this feels like the logical next step. Just ask the plant how it's doing and have it tell you what it needs. Using the connected microphone and speaker, you can talk to your plants all day long. If your plant cops an attitude, or if you always considered your tomato plants to have a sweeter, higher pitched voice, you can make some adjustments in the settings. But really, this recipe can be recycled for anything you can imagine. Maybe you want to talk to your house, or your car, or your fish tank. It all comes down to the sensors and how you set up the core prompt. You can find a link to the guide down in the description. More projects. On Instructables, andrei.erdei shows how he made this totally unique Voronoi pattern light sculpture. The whole enclosure is 3D printed in three main sections: a base where the addressable LEDs are individually wired and spaced, an insert of channels that define the shape for each light, and a translucent cover that helps to diffuse the light and, depending on your build plate, provides the overall texture. The microcontroller here is a Wemos D1 Mini, which I think in this case still uses the older ESP8266 chip. He's loaded it with Arduino code that loops a number of fading LED animations. The code is included with the guide, though he also says that setting this up with the WLED software would be an easy way to go as well. I'm really impressed with how this looks. Though it has me wondering about how dressing it up with a milled wood enclosure to hide the layer lines could take it to the next level. There's also a great video up from Liz at Blitz City DIY. Liz shows how she created her own custom audio patch bay to route connections from the back of her new keyboard to a more easily accessible panel on her desktop. As a bonus customization, each channel has an LED light associated with it, so not only is it more ergonomic, but you can quickly see what channels are active. Now for some tips and tools. On her blog, Charlyn Gonda shows how she was able to turn Adafruit's Neo Key Trinky into a one-click shutdown button for the Raspberry Pi. Not only is it an inexpensive solution, but it's one of the coolest looking options I've seen, and it can be dressed up with your own custom keycap. By way of Gear's Tips and Tools newsletter, which I highly recommend, I found this video from the Logs Carving Club channel that demonstrates how to use every flavor of Dremel bit imaginable. There are some interesting new and third-party bits shown here. We also get to see some of the Easy Lock accessories, which I enjoy and really changed how I use my Dremel. And on his YouTube channel, Jeremy Fielding has a useful and thorough guide on how to CAD model and work with custom gears. Not only do you get a ton of practical advice and useful terminology, but you also get some solid advice for working with motors and gears in general. Jeremy is amazing and exactly who I'd want to learn this stuff from. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, thinking back on how that AI talking plant project is limited only really by the variety of sensors you're working with, let's take a look at sensors on DigiKey. They have a whole category here organized by different types of sensing. You have sensors that detect color, liquid flow, different types of gas, humidity, magnetism, motion, pressure, light, everything you can imagine. Just looking at a page like this can spark some ideas. You can find a link down in the description. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. Big thanks as always to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.